Hello and welcome. In this video I'm going to show you how to fix the dead center on your Saitek Pro Flight Yoke system. We're going to upgrade the original 10-bit controller with a Leo Bodnar board. The Brabo Uniform 0836 Alpha board allows conversion from analog to digital signals with a 12-bit resolution, so 4096 steps. As always, let's begin by evaluating the current situation, and as you can tell, the sensitivity is crapped around the center position. So let's disassemble the unit as we did it on my previous video. Check out my other videos if you want to learn more about this rubber band mod. The roll and the pitch in this yoke are controlled by these two potentiometers. They're a bit crappy to be fair, but we're gonna stick with them for now. What we need to do now is rewire the potentiometers to our new board. So let's begin by getting rid of the original cables. The Leo Bodnar board is compatible with buttons, encoders and so on and so forth, but I'm only interested in the roll and the pitch, and that is because all the other signals give no trouble. Buttons are either high or low, so 0 and 1, and they don't give any resolution problem. So I'm not going to be rewiring all the Saitek Pro Flight yoke on the Leo Bodnar, only the roll and the pitch. And for convenience, I'm replacing the original cables with these female headers. Okay, so the potentiometer has three cables: ground, voltage in, and the signal. My initial guess is that the ground is black, the voltage is red, and the signal is the other cable, which in this case was yellow.
One eternity later.
So after wiring the potentiometers, I plug them in to the Leo Bodnar board. The roll goes first and then the pitch. Again, my common sense tells me this is the correct wiring. Well, that is wrong. The ground cable is indeed black, but then the voltage in is yellow and the signal is red for some stupid reason. Anyway, moving on, I'm here making the hole to accommodate the USB cable. One of the original screws can be used to accommodate the board. And I think it's not a bad idea to twist the cables to prevent any noise. Okay, so we're almost done. The USB cable can be plugged into the port hub in the Saitek Pro Flight system itself. It's very convenient because then we only need to use the original USB cable. Now, when we connect the yoke into the computer, we're gonna see two controllers, the Saitek Pro Flight itself and the new board. So let's go ahead and calibrate it as usual. As the original controller is only 10 bits, we now have 4 times more resolution. And of course, don't forget to configure your controls in your flight simulator. This is how it should look like. And well, that was a success. It is now very sensitive, very smooth, and I'm sure this will help in the landing flare and many other maneuvers. Thank you for watching, and I hope you found it useful. Bye-bye.